And greetings, this is your friendly neighbor Tud Taronin, and I thought we'd go take a look at the Leopard 1. And this is not the Leopard A2 with the boxy turrets and all that. It's a served side by side with the M60s and the M48s and what have you. It was upgraded, and I believe a lot were shipped over to Canada and various other countries bought them. It was quite the export success, along with the patent series. And I believe most of Europe carried these, with the exception of France and Britain, which manufacture their own armor. Carried a 105mm gun, pretty quick. It's a little faster than the M48 series, patent series. This M48, and there was an M48A5, M60A1, 2, and 3, if I remember right. And in the last game, as you can see, I used that superior speed to run out ahead of everybody else and get myself killed. So we're obviously going to have to be a little more careful, aren't we? Okay, so the cartel blew out the train tunnel and derailed the train and stole the supplies on board while ISD tries to get everything back on track. And apparently we work for International Security Detail. If I follow the line correctly here, I really got to get into the lore a little bit. And we will start here in just a minute or two. Well, we have more main battle tanks this time. Maybe that'll help a little bit. Oh, thank you. Sometimes our friends are less than helpful. Well, worst comes to worst, get in front of the other guy and take the shot and block him with your tank. Well, I'm glad I was on the other side of that. Well, you can tell I'm a noob sometimes. Well, all the time, really. Okay, so we're heading off to the next objective, I believe. There's the little blue flag in the distance. And let's run into a rock and prove that I'm the great driver that I really think I am. And we'll move on around. And once again, we have somebody in our way. Lovely. Okay. Okay. Something tells me from that dust geyser just went up, there's somebody up there that doesn't like me. Sorry about the sign, it's getting old. It's virtually every time I try to move. I'll put that rock between me and him while I reload. Let's get out of here. Okay, so one enemy spotted, six destroyed. Guess I did okay after all. Made some progress there. And there you have the M60A2. And we're going to upgrade this. I saw some things on here I really would like to upgrade, so let's see if we can afford one of these. We got the fire control system that reduces aim time by 20%. That's a Hesh. And Hesh is a high explosive squash head. And what it does, it essentially is a thin shell strong enough to withstand the firing from a tank gun. And when it reaches its target, what it does is it pancakes against the armor and then explodes. And that pancake of explosive, what it does is causes a spall on the inside. Now, against modern armors and their composite natures, of all of which are highly classified, it's not so effective. And then they have things like Kevlar spall linings, which will actually catch that and stop the crew from being injured. So you don't see it anymore, but the British Army was just in love with it. In fact, there were all the reasons that they stayed with the rifled 120 millimeter cannon was so they could keep Hesh. Now it's still incredibly effective against buildings and what have you. So they may still be using it to this day, for all I know. And for lesser systems such as APCs and what have you, it works about pretty well. Okay. And well, you get the improved torsion bar. And we're good to go. That's all I really want to do to this. All right. So we are set up. This is going to be video number four in the Armored Warfare series. And let's see what we got in our inventory here. And what I'm doing is showing off various things here. So we'll go ahead and well, we got some cash there. Get plus 10 reputation for it. Another 25,000 in credit there, or whatever they are. I guess that's experience. Fifteen silver commander experience. So we got some insignias we can apply here. Reputation. So we got some stuff we can use later if I start slowing down. I go to dealer here, and we can actually you see where I've upgraded the aircraft. I play World Warplanes way too much. QF-40 is next on this line. Then we have the Leopard 1A5, and then we start moving to the Leopard 2 and down that line. And I still have a request for tank destroyers. You gotta believe that is it right there. Followed by the Dragoon, and then you have the APCs with various things on them. Okay, so you have a little bit of an overview there. If you want to make suggestions on things you want to see in armored modern armor, let me know and we'll certainly do it. This is uncharted territory. I'm not nearly as familiar with this as I am World of Warplanes. Still got tons to learn, but we'll improve and gives you an idea of what the vehicles are and what they can do for you. Do appreciate you all have a great day and we'll see you soon. Bye bye.